everyone, my name is Sandra. Welcome to Squamish in British Columbia. Welcome to your practice. We are sitting in front of the chief, this huge wall right behind me. And as you can see, there are some climbers on the wall finding the way all the way to the top. Now, if you're struggling with tension in your lower back, whether this comes from climbing too much or sitting too much on your office chair all day long, this mellow sequence will hopefully do something about it and bring some kind of relief. So personally, my own back is pretty crappy right now from carrying two heavy backpacks for too many days in a row. And what helps me personally is mobilization. So in phases of acute pain, we don't want to focus on strengthening. We don't want to bring even more tension to muscles that are already feeling super tight, but we want to mobilize them instead and encourage blood flow to those areas of the body that are all tightened up. If you know that your pain is originally related to structural problems such as sacroiliac joint pain or prolapses, you want to be extra careful, really, and you want to be even more mindful when it comes working with your pain. So you really want to make sure you're listening to your body, you're respecting its limits, and you want to try to differentiate between what we call good pain and bad pain. Now, bad pain feels exclusively bad and wrong, basically, as opposed to good pain, which has some kind of yummy and relieving aspects really about it. Now, having said that, we want to you want to make sure you have something like a block. If you don't have a block, use a thick book or something of like a similar size like this one. And we want to begin, just have the block right next to your yoga mat, you want to have it handy. We begin in child's pose. So you want to open your knees maybe a little bit wider than you usually do in child's pose and allow your upper body to just sink deep, releasing down. A few moments here, allowing your body to arrive on the mat. Allowing your mind to arrive in your body. Directing your attention towards your breath. Directing your breath a little bit deeper into the backside of your rib cage. And directing your breath into those places of your back that need a little bit more of attention, a little bit more of softening. Face relaxed. Now from here, you want to bring your knees a little bit closer together. Straighten your arms. So you want to reach your fingertips a little bit further to the front. And your hands pressing down into the floor. So you want to reach through your fingertips and lengthen from the fingertips to your sacrum. Your forehead can still remain on the floor. Make sure your elbows are straight, your arms engaged. And from here, you want to shift your weight all the way onto your hands forward. So your shoulders are moving above, forward towards your, above your wrists. And you want to round your back strongly. Let your head be heavy, your tailbone is heavy, heavy, heavy. Kind of a wave-like movement. And once you reach the front, you allow your navel to sink down, broaden the shoulder blades and lift your heart. Upward facing dog with your knees on the floor. So your arms want to be engaged, roll the shoulders back, broaden the collarbones, and then from here just allow one hip after the other to sink down a little bit. Already this bringing gentle mobilization to your lower back. If you find it's too much for the lower back, you just make the movement a little bit smaller and draw the navel a little bit in, engaging the core slightly. Before we meet back in the center, from here you draw the navel in, head sinks down, tailbone is heavy. In this wave-like manner, you want to move back onto your heels again. Let's do that again. Press your hands down, shift your weight forward as you round your spine forward, forward, forward. And at the very top only, you want to lift and open the chest, rolling the shoulders back. As you exhale, draw the navel in. Tailbone is heavy, head is heavy, sit all the way back. As you inhale next time, round your spine forward again, this wave-like movement. At the very top of your inhale, lift and broaden the chest. On your exhale, draw the navel in, sitting back in your child's pose. One last time, round your spine forward, spread your shoulder blades wide as you do so. On your exhale, draw the navel in, sit all the way back, and step your hands further to the front this time, so your hips end up above your knees, more or less, in this downward facing dog, but with knees on the floor. Your upper body's in downward facing dog shape. Engage your arms. If you want to rest the forehead on the floor, you can do so. So arms engaged, guide your sit bones back. And then from here you allow the right hip to sink down a bit, then you allow the left hip to sink down a bit, kind of twisting motion, swinging your hips a little bit from side to side. Gently mobilizing, wakening up the whole body, especially the back. Face relaxed and soft. The gazing from one armpit to the other is a twisting, gentle twisting motion. Before we come all the way back to center, walk your hands towards your knees, cross your ankles and come all the way to a cross-legged position. You might want to sit on a block or something if that's more comfortable. You want to be able to upright your spine. I'm just turning around so you can see me better. We start with our right foot in front of, with our right shin in front of the left shin. Hands resting on your knees, upright your spine. Crown of your head is reaching tall, shoulders relaxed away from your ears. And then from here we start to create circles in our spine. And I want you to make the circle widest at the height of your solar plexus. So you try to keep your shoulders and your head as much as possible above your hips, really. And the circle is widest at the height of your solar plexus. Continue breathing. And if you find a spot, like what we would call an interesting spot, really, where you feel tension, where you feel pain and tension, you might want to stay there a little bit and breathe into the muscles. And from here we come all the way back to center. Crown of your head is reaching high towards the sky. Lean a tiny little bit back, only to alternate the cross of your legs. Hands go back to your knees, and then we do the same thing on the second side. So you want to circle all the way in the other direction. Again, the circle wants to be widest at the height of your solar plexus. So you might want to imagine you're scraping the inside of a salad bowl with your spine, kind of stirring the air. Continue breathing. From here, we're coming all the way back to center. Crown of your head is reaching high, shoulders relaxed. From here, we come to ankle to knee pose. So your left ankle goes onto your right knee, and your right ankle directly underneath the left knee. If your hips aren't open enough yet to do so, no problem to have your left shin just in front of your right shin, with your left ankle exactly in front of your right knee. Bring your hands back onto your knees. If you want to sit higher, very welcome to do so. So lower back issues are very often associated with tightness in our hips as well. So we don't want to forget about doing some hip openers. And we start by addressing the external hip rotators right now, as you might already feel. So bringing your hands to your hips, you encourage arching your lower back really. So you stick your butt out as you inhale. And now as you exhale, that relieves the stretch probably a tiny little bit. You round your spine, a little bit of a cat-cow movement. As you inhale, lift your chest, stick your butt out. As you exhale, round your spine. Again, inhale, lift your heart. On your exhale, round your spine. Head is heavy. Inhale, lift your heart, stick your butt out. On your exhale, round your spine again. One more time. Inhale, lift your heart. And then from here, you want to take your left leg and swing it all the way back. Get hold of your left ankle. Now we're getting into the hip flexors. We need some opening here as well. They might contribute to the pain we are experiencing in our lower back really. So what you want to do is you want to pull your left foot close towards your left sit bone. Right hand goes next to you, a little bit behind your fingertips on the floor. Now lift your heart and observe what happens when you roll the left hip forward. Just play a little bit with it. You will immediately feel there's something happening in your left hip flexor. Nice one. A nice pose, especially for those who want to experience this stretch but can't be on the knee. There are many like the lunges with knee on the floor. Some people can't do them because the knee just doesn't like it. Breathe, roll the left hip forward, breathing into your left groin. From here, swing your left leg all the way back to the front, changing sides. So your right ankle goes on top of your left knee. Left ankle goes underneath the right knee. If this is too much, just have the right shin right in front of the left shin. But make sure the left ankle is underneath the right knee, not too close to your buttocks, because it makes a big difference in your hip rotator muscle, really. Get hold of your knee, of your foot. So by pulling back, you arch your lower back and will experience the opening of the hip rotator muscles again. On your exhale, draw the navel in, some kind of relief in your hip, in the rotator muscles again. As you inhale, going back into the muscles, into the stretch. Lift your heart. Exhale, round your spine. Inhale, lift. Roll the shoulders back. Exhale, round your spine, draw the shoulder blades apart. Inhale, lift your chest. Again, round your spine, head is heavy. Inhale, lift your heart. From here, you want to swing your right leg all the way back and get hold of your right ankle, pulling it a little bit closer towards your sit bone, left fingertips next to you on the floor. Lift your heart and roll the right hip forward. Explore how far you want to go, respecting your limits, of course. Lifting your heart and guiding your breath deep into those parts of your body that attract most attention right now. So when it comes to this good pain we were talking about before, you want to be able to breathe deeply. So that's also like a good indicator whether you're working with good pain. So breathing can still happen. You're not like holding the breath because it's so bad. Deep cleansing breath. From here, you want to swing your right leg all the way back to the front, coming to cross-legged from where you roll over your knees or you swing your legs back, meeting in our tabletop position. Knees are hip-width apart, underneath your hips, and hands directly underneath your shoulders. Spread the fingers wide. On your exhale, let's come into cat pose, round your spine, draw the navel in, head is really, really heavy. Inhale, let your navel sink down and lift your heart, roll the shoulders back. As you exhale, draw the navel in, tailbone sinks down. On your inhale, lift your heart, navel sinks down. So in cow pose, navel sinks down, and as you exhale, draw the navel in cat pose. In your own breathing rhythm, continue a few more times. And what you want to try to do is to initiate this movement in your tailbone. So the tailbone guides the movement, and then the rest of the spine follows. So the movement is kind of rippling up all the way, all through the spine, finally arriving in the neck and the head. And the next time you are in cat pose, you want to stay there. You want to spread the shoulder blades really, really wide and breathe deeply in between the shoulder blades. Drawing the navel in. And the next time you inhale, allow the navel to sink down again. Lift your heart, roll the shoulders back. Stay there for a few cycles of breath. This time guiding your breath deep into the center of your heart. And observe on how the rib cage is moving, expanding each time you inhale. Curl your toes under. And then from here, you want to just lift your knees away from the floor. Guide your sit bones high towards the sky. And walk your hands a bit further to the front so we get into our first downward facing dog. Head is heavy. Start with keep your knees bent. So we want to encourage a little bit more length in the lower back. And if you like, you want to start to do these walking moves. So straightening and bending one leg after the other. And then allowing your whole body to be part of this movement, twisting and turning your rib cage from side to side, gazing underneath one armpit after the other, as if you were massaging your own body, kneading your body. Spread the fingers wide, grounding through every knuckle. Continue breathing. Before we come all the way back to center, meeting in our downward facing dog for a few cycles of breath. Guiding your sit bones high. You want to make sure you encourage length in the lower back. So rather than being over ambitious and straightening those legs, you might want to keep them bent if that means that you find the length in your lower back we want to be working with, really. And spread the toes wide. You might be able to lift those toes a little bit away from the floor and then spread them, ground them all the way back to the floor, making sure we're not collapsing in our inner ankles. So we're gently lifting the inner ankles and encouraging the arches of our feet to lift a tiny little bit. So we tend to collapse. The feet tend to collapse inward, pronate. On your next inhale, shift your weight forward into plank pose, unrushed. You want to roll the shoulders back, crown of the head reaches forward. On your exhale, push it back into your downward facing dog. Two more times as you inhale, shift your weight slowly forward, legs engage, crown of the head reaches. Exhale, push it back. Once more, shift your weight forward, make sure your navel is drawing in, lengthen the tailbone, exhale, push it all the way back. Step your feet step by step all the way to the top of the yoga mat, into our standing forward bend. And to start with, keep your knees bent. Even if your range of motion would allow you to keep your legs straight, allow the knees to bend and allow your tummy to rest on your thighs. Get hold of your opposite side elbows behind your calves. Behind the calves. Allow your head to be heavy and your spine to just round. And then from here, just guide your inhale deep into the lower portion of your back. So each time you inhale, try to find space there. And each time you exhale, release. Release your arms slowly down to the floor. Head being heavy and keeping your knees bent. Lift your heart, place your hands on your knees. Knees wanna be bent. Lift your heart, roll the shoulders back, stick your butt out. And we do a kind of cat-cow movement again in a standing position. And we initiate the movement like we've done before in the tailbone. So that's pretty important with that one. So now as you exhale next time, the tailbone guides the movement. So guide the tailbone down and let the rest of the spine follow, rounding your spine. Head is heavy, navel draws in. As you inhale, tailbone initiates the movement again. Navel sinks down, lift and broaden your upper body. Exhale. Round the spine, allow the tailbone to initiate the movement. Inhale, lift your heart. Continue on your own breathing rhythm. And as the tailbone sinks down, being heavy, imagine you would move it down and forward even. Continue breathing, continue moving, mobilizing your spine. Face remains relaxed. Allow the breath to flow through your body. Now the next time you inhale and you roll the shoulders back and you stick your butt out, stay there. Place your right elbow on your right knee. Straighten, lengthen your spine, keep it long. Straighten your left leg, then open all the way to the left. Left hand goes to your left hip, or you reach your left fingertips high towards the sky. Now, if your range of motion allows you to do so, you can bring your right fingertips on the floor. You use a block, but you want to make sure that this doesn't affect the length in your lower back. Now, lean your upper body a little bit more back in space. Keeping both feet equally grounded. Make sure you're not clenching your toes. Another deep inhale, and as you exhale, release down. Head is heavy. Both knees bend, release all the way down. As you inhale, lift your spine, roll the shoulders back, left elbow onto your left knee, and as you exhale, second side, open to your right side, and find a variation that suits your body the most. Finding a middle path between not too much and not too little. Respecting your limits and your body's needs. Another deep inhale here. As you exhale, release all the way down, knees bend. Inhale, lift your heart, push your feet down, sweep your arms out to the sides, come to standing, join your palms, exhale. Release your arms down by the sides of your body. Make sure your feet are parallel, pushing down underneath your sit bones. And gently drawing the navel in, gently lengthening the tailbone down, open your heart. Spread the fingers wide, palms of your hands face the front. Feel how your shoulder blades firm against the back of your ribs. Crown of the head reaches. Now as your feet push down, sweep your arms out as you inhale. Lift your heart, lift your gaze, a tiny back bend on top. Exhale, move your chest forward, forward, halfway down. Bend your knees, release your upper body down. Inhale, half standing forward, bend, lengthen your spine. Hands can go to the shins, to the knees. Exhale, release down, bend the knees a tiny bit. Inhale, lift your heart, push the feet down, come all the way to standing. Join those palms together. One more half sun salutation. Arms out and up. Lift your heart and gaze. Exhale, move your chest forward unrushed. Standing forward bend. Inhale, half standing forward bend. Shoulders roll back. Exhale, release down. Inhale, lift your heart. Sweep your arms out to the sides. Join your palms. Exhale. Sweep your arms out as you inhale. On your exhale, sweep your arms to the sides and twist to the right side. Reach through your fingertips as you sweep your arms to the sides and down. Inhale, reach your arms to the sides and up and come back to the front to center. Exhale, same thing, second side, opening and twisting to the left. Inhale, sweep your arms out to the sides and up. Exhale, one more time to the right. Inhale, sweep your arms out to the sides and up. Exhale to the left. Inhale, sweep your arms out to the sides, reaching through your fingertips. Exhale, bring your hands back together in front of your heart. Sweep your arms out as you inhale. Lift your heart and gaze. Gaze up. Exhale, move your chest forward and dive down. Standing forward bend. Lift and lengthen halfway, half standing forward bend. Exhale, release down. Take small steps back into your downward facing dog again. Maybe working with your knees being slightly bent, encourage length in your lower back, guiding your sit bones diagonally towards the spine, towards the sky. Face is relaxed. Your hands pushing down and forward, your feet pushing down and back as if you wanted to give your yoga mat a nice stretch. Shift your weight forward, plank pose, core engaged, knees to the floor, cross your ankles again. We're sitting all the way back once more, coming to a cross-legged position. Again, I'm turning around so you can see me from the front. We start with our right shin in front of the left shin again, and you might want to sit a little bit higher so you can upright your spine again. Sweep your arms out as you inhale, reach through your fingertips. On your exhale, let's twist to the right side, right fingertips behind you, and left hand goes to your left, to your right knee or thigh. Try to distribute the twist equally through your whole spine. And allow breathing to happen, feeling your breath, allowing your breath to oscillate the spine, to oscillate your upper body. So each time you inhale, you find a bit more length, and each time you exhale, you release a little bit more into the twist. So as you inhale, you come a tiny little bit out of the twist, and as you exhale, as if you want to wring out your spine, a little bit more into the twist. From here, you keep your left hand where it is, and then you just lean a little bit forward into the left, so your left shoulder wants to go a little bit closer. Now, it does not need to be much to the left knee. The right hand goes to the right side of your lower back, which you might feel at this point. This is the area one attacks, and it's quite difficult to get into, to get a nice stretch in that area. So just place your hand onto the lower back where you feel it the most and guide your breath deep into it as you roll the right shoulder back. You might also feel it like a little bit into the, in the oblique muscles. On your inhale, come all the way back to upright, crown of the head reaches, and as you exhale, once more into the twist, so right fingertips back behind you on the floor. Make sure your spine is growing tall and you're not leaning back. As you inhale, sweep your arms out to the sides and up all the way back to center. As you exhale, release your arms down. Lean a little bit back and alternate the cross of your legs. Growing tall. Sweep your arms out as you inhale, reaching through your fingertips. On your exhale, twist to the left with your right hand going to your opposite side Leg, left fingertips behind you. Make sure your chin doesn't drop. And feel your upper body oscillating with your breath. Observe on how your exhale helps you to release into the twist. You don't want to force it. Especially when you already have intention and tight muscles in your lower back. Twists often, if we overdo them, build up even more tension in the back muscles, and we don't want this to happen. So even more than usual, be super mindful about not overdoing the whole thing, but rather breathing yourself into the twist, rather than forcing yourself into the twist. Right hand stays where it is. Your right shoulder goes a little bit closer towards your right knee, while your left hand plays your palm flat onto the lower and left side of your back. As you roll the left shoulder back, breathe into your palm and breathe into the muscles you feel the most right now. It's likely that it's different compared to the other side. It's just something else to bring attention to. You don't want to overdo the twist in your neck, so maybe it just feels nicer to gaze rather to the front. But don't let your head just hang. On your inhale, come back to upright, crown of the head reaches. And as you exhale, release once more into your twist to the left, without overdoing again the twist in your neck. Distributing the twist equally, like a spiral, through your whole spine. On your next inhale, come all the way back to center. And from where you want to swing your legs to the left. Again, you might want to sit on something. It's a little bit of an asymmetric way of sitting, but there's no problem about that, really. So if you're comfortable, just sit without anything underneath your sit bone. Sweep your arms out again as you inhale, reaching through the fingertips. And as you exhale, a gentle and simple twist to the right side. Rolling the right shoulder back. As you inhale, sweep your arms out to the sides and up. And as you exhale, we bend over to the left. Left hand goes to the floor, and you want to reach through your right fingertips. Continue breathing here. We stay for a few cycles of breath. You want to make sure we're not collapsing in the left shoulder. So relax the left shoulder away from your left ear. Right palm is facing down. You want to reach as much as you can through your right fingertips. So you want to lengthen from the right hip point through the right fingertips as you spiral your chest a tiny bit further up towards the sky. Guiding your breath deep into the right side of your ribcage. Inhale, come all the way back to center. Exhale, release your arms down. Lean a little bit back, only to swing your legs all the way to the second side. Relaxing the shoulders away from your ears. Sweep your arms out to the sides and up. Exhale, twist to your left. Rolling the left shoulder back. Make sure the chin doesn't drop. Continue breathing. We call this the simple twist, so you want to keep the simple twist simple. Allowing the breath to help you release a little bit more in the twist. Try to find space rather than forcing yourself. Inhale, sweep your arms out to the sides, come back to center. And as you exhale, bring your right hand to the floor. Reaching through your left fingertips, make sure your left elbow is straight. Makes a huge difference. And you don't have to bend over that much. So just explore and try to get the most out of it. You want to be able to breathe deep into the left side of your ribcage. And maybe also guiding the breath more consciously into the lower left portion of your back. Right shoulder relaxing away from your ear. Inhale, come all the way back to center. Exhale, release your arms down. Swing your legs, both legs back to the front. And you might need to wiggle a little bit further to the front of your yoga mat. So you have all the space you need to lie down, hands on the floor. Then bring your elbows to the floor and very slowly, mindfully, vertebra per vertebra, roll all the way down, drawing the navel in. You want to have the block handy at this point. Sorry, I forgot to say that. Block should be handy. Have your feet hip joint width apart. Your feet want to be parallel and your arms want to be by the sides of your body. Lengthen your neck. You want to make sure the back of your skull is releasing down into the floor. From here, you want to draw the navel in. As you draw the navel in, feel your lower back grounding and your tailbone is slightly lifting away from the floor, just a tiny little bit, and then just release again. Let's combine this with our breathing. As you exhale, you gently draw the navel in, feel the lower back grounding as if you scoop your tailbone away from the back of your skull, tailbone gently lifting. As you inhale, release again. Make sure your neck is relaxed and long. Exhale, draw the navel in, feel your lower back grounding. Inhale, release. Continue in your own breathing rhythm. And what you might want to add is like a gentle engagement of your pelvic floor muscles each time that you ground the lower back and each time that you exhale. Making sure you keep your face relaxed and soft. A gentle mobilization of the lower back, even a kind of a massage, a gentle lower back massage you're giving to yourself. Now the next time you exhale and the next time you're grounding the lower back, you want to push your feet down a little bit more and keep on scooping your tailbone away from the back of your skull so that your lower back gently lifts. Push your feet down so your buttocks lifts, your sacrum lifts. You want to get hold of your block or whatever you're using and place it underneath the sacrum. You decide how high you wanna rest with your pelvis, whether you wanna choose like the lowest height, the mid height, or the highest. And then just allow your belly to relax, maybe flip-flop the feet a bit further apart so your knees can rather fall towards each other, so you don't wanna hold your legs or anything. Just release and relax in this passive backbend. And allowing your breath even more here to deepen. And as you exhale next time, gently open your lips and allow your exhale to release through your lips. And each time you exhale, allow your body to soften and to let go of all unnecessary tension even more. Let's have a few more cycles of breath here. Before, you want to flip-flop your feet a bit closer together again. You want to push your feet firmly down into the floor in order to be able to lift your buttocks, in order to be able to remove the block. If you feel pain in your lower back kicking in at this point, try to engage the pelvic floor a tiny bit and see whether that helps. And then slowly remove the block and really slowly roll down vertebra per vertebra. Now before going into Shavasana, we want to one more hip opening. It's a really nice one, where you want to place your right ankle on top of your left knee. Reach your arms to the sides and keep your right ankle on your left knee. So keep this figure four shape in your legs and just allow your body to twist to the left, so your right foot ends up on the floor. Now get hold of your right ankle with your left hand and maybe pull the ankle a little bit closer towards your close and higher up your left thigh. And maybe your head wants to roll counter to the right side. And in order to get a little bit more into the another interesting point of our hip rotator muscles, you want to explore a little bit what it does to the pose, sticking your butt out a little bit, so accentuating the arch in your lower back. Just play a little bit with it and see, and try to find a position that you would call interesting, really, and helpful. Guiding your breath deep, again, deep into the part of your body that attracts the most attention right now. Let's have another two cycles of breath here. Before you unwind your legs slowly, come all the way back to center. Placing your left ankle on top of your right knee, allowing your left knee to fall to the side and reach your arms to the sides. Twisting all the way to the right side until the left foot goes into the floor. Right hand is grabbing your left ankle. And maybe you want to roll your head counter. And again, playing a little bit with this pose. Want to try to accentuate the arch in your lower back, and maybe also play with the positioning of your knee. Some people find it more helpful to have the knee falling rather towards the floor. It really depends on the body. So try to investigate a little bit what works best for you and your body at this point. Deep breathing. Deep and cleansing breath. Unrushed, unwind your legs. Come all the way back to center. Place your feet to the floor. From where you extend one leg after the other, preparing for Shavasana. Now, if you struggle with quite acute lower back pain, you might find it uncomfortable to just lie on your back like that. Then try and have a rolled blanket or something underneath your knees, which might make it way more comfortable for your lower back. Release and relax. You want to make sure you don't need to hold your tummy. Really be able to let go. Allow your palms to face the sky. And allow the whole weight of your body to just melt down. Release your body down into the floor. Nothing to hold. And directing your attention back to your breathing. And using your breath to release even more. Each time you exhale, allow all unnecessary tension to just let go. Allow your next breath to be a little bit deeper. And slowly start to wiggle your toes and your fingers a little bit. Reach your arms above your head if that feels like the right thing to do. Reaching through your hands, through your fingertips, through your feet. Before you bend one leg after the other and roll all the way onto your right side. From where you use your hands and come all the way back to sit. You might want to keep your eyes closed for a few more moments. Meeting in a cross-legged position. With your hands resting on your knees or your thighs. And the crown of your head to reach high towards the sky. And take a few more moments to check in. Still try to keep your judgmental mind quiet. And join your palms in front of your chest and allow your thumbs to touch your breastbone. And the next time you exhale, slowly open your eyes again. Namaste. I thank you for joining, and I hope you find or you found this helpful for your lower back.